Okay, so how do we get started with the templates? Let's take a look. If you go to Planoly.com and log in if you have an account or join free using either Google, Autodesk, Procore, or some others, otherwise add your email and password. I'm sure you know how to do that. I've actually got an account already. Fancy that. So I can log into it and automatically be presented with my projects that I already have. When you log in, you'll see a different screen for the first time. So if I say templates, and hit save. What this will be is the screen that you'll see. You'll see all of the options for those templates. And we can simply click the ones we would like. We can choose which parts maybe we do not want to have included. And when we, hey, what the heck, let's just create all of them. And hit create. What that's doing is gathering all of those documents and putting them into that one plan tab so that all of them appear, as you can see here, with the OIR, PIR, EIR, etc. So if I open these, you can see each of these and appointment documents, risks, mobilization, all of this fun stuff. And all of these templates are ready for you to complete. The next part is the scope. And whilst we have some fantastic scope templates too, what I would recommend is to start with an empty scope. You can try some of these other ones out, but if you start with an empty scope, you'll be presented with the library. And the library of elements that you can get started with, you can start to create anything from conceptual, so from a site model, to zones, to elements, to documents. So for example, here, if we look at the document library, maybe there's a cost plan that's required and some certificates. And this would be potentially part of the master information delivery plan as well. And if we go back to the element library, we can start to complement that with some elements as well. All of this can then be put into hierarchies and folders, and using the level of information need concept, we can then put the requirements in a project. So I'm just jumping to another one here where we've got the Uniclass classification structure and then some elements that we would then have in either Reba stages. So we can see the Reba stages here, or we can break into the stages and then see each of the model uses that are required. So for each model use, we have different sets of elements. And maybe, for example, at the asset information model, at the end of the day, we don't need anything from foundations. Maybe we need something from some of the other systems. And if we dig right in, these tanks, we require certain parameters as well. So we can get into a lot more detail, master information delivery plan, task information delivery plan, RACI charts, level of information need, BIM execution planning, employers information requirements, exchange information requirements, appointment documents, risk management, all of that is available to us. So let's dig in and use the templates. And there's a place down at the bottom of this webpage as well for registering interest to become part of the review team. So these are templates for your teams to get started with, but we also really value the continuous improvement of these. So they're not just a set of templates that are gathering dust. They are continually reviewed and improved by about 150 experts around the world today. And hopefully that will grow with more and more interest from people like yourself.